chicken drumsticks? Wow, I am so excited to eat this. I love chicken.
I know you do. You really love chicken drumsticks, don't you? So, Dad, since our summer vacation started, what are we gonna do over summer?
Well, Joey, we were about to tell you and Justin some exciting news. Next Wednesday, we are going to Grandma and Grandpa's house in Washington, D.C. Our cousins will also be there. We will go on the Amtrak Acela. Isn't that exciting?
That is so exciting. I can't wait for Wednesday next week.
Same with me.
Because of the trip, I think it's time we start packing up our luggage tomorrow.
Who's ready for the train trip?
I am.
I am.
I am.
Then let's go.
Dude, what's wrong? Why are you angry?
What is this? Why are we in the first car? I have a problem with that.
Seriously, Justin? What is your problem with sitting in the first car of a train? You're not making sense.
I hate the stupid first car. I only like the middle cars and the last car. I want to go to either the middle car or the last car.
Justin, knock this attitude off. You are acting like a baby.
We understand that you don't like sitting in the first car, but in our ticket, we were assigned a specific seat and we can't switch.
Now can you just chill out already and deal with this? Nothing is wrong with sitting in the first car.
Justin, Joey has a fair point. In life, you won't get everything you like 24/7.
Even I don't like the first car. Am I whining about it?
Stop acting so childish. I'm serious, Justin. Just sit and enjoy the ride. I thought you were excited for the train ride.
No, I want to sit in a different car than this, and that's final.
What part of in life, you won't get everything you like 24/7? Did you not understand?
Please, Mom, Dad, and Joey, I beg us to go to another train car. I don't like the first car. It's just stupid. That's why I don't like it.
For the last time, no. You don't understand the meaning of assigned seat either. Now, I want you to calm down and take deep breaths. And also start thinking that sitting in the first car is a big deal, big problem or little problem?
It is an extremely huge problem.
Incorrect. It's not even close to a big problem. It is such a teeny tiny problem. A big problem would be an emergency like a fire in a building.
Okay. Well, I guess it's a small problem. I will stop whining. This has actually been a fun ride.
Good job. Now that's more like it. You are now thinking sitting in the first car you don't like is no big deal. That's behaving mature. But just remember to behave the rest of the way.
Joey, do you want to look outside the window? We can tell each other what we see.
Sure.